Hello, family and friends. Welcome to the Wolf Nation. Our nation of truth, factual truth. We have a heavy downpour here again today. The hurricane touched down the Jersey Shore, so we're having it. It happens. That's the weather. And they knew it would happen to us. They predicted it, and it's happening. Not by God's thought, says the Lord. Jesus said, the word of God said, no. And you should know there's nothing new under the sun. The day you understand that there's nothing new under the sun, you will discard prophecies. All those things. Some people have ability to study the weather, they study nature and make predictions. It has nothing to do with divinity or supernatural power. Supernatural being, they are all natural power, natural ability, insight, understanding, knowledge. And that's the area the spiritual people or religious people don't want to get. They spiritualize natural things and they religialize natural things. Instead of operating by knowledge, they operate by faith. Oh, somebody yesterday was commenting on my post, asking me what is spirituality. I said, spirituality is organized religion, period. So it's like he don't believe in God, but he said that spirituality is thought. Say thought is spirituality. I laugh. Okay, if you say your thought is spiritual, okay, because you be, it's natural. You are the one doing the thought or the thoughting. He has not. You are natural. You know, you are not spiritual. You cannot go through a wall. You cannot disappear and appear unless you make up something which is also part of nature. It has nothing to do with spirituality. But those natural forces we have, some people decided to spiritualize it and to religialize it, which creates hierarchy among us. Or somebody thinking he is better than you or greater than you because they have certain abilities. No, everyone have peculiar abilities. There's ability I have that you don't have, and there's ability you have that I don't have. Nothing I have makes me better human being than you. Nothing. And anything you think that makes you better human being than me makes you evil person. And that's why you have evil people. Evil people are people who decided to put themselves above their fellow human beings, thinking because they know certain things or they have attained certain level, then others are their slaves. Others are not like human beings. So that's what makes them evil. Anything that is against nature. In nature, we all are equal. We all. Nobody came from heaven. Nobody came from a tree. I mean, human beings. No, all of us came through the body of a woman. All of us. Whether maybe you were, your mother was operated upon to take you out, they call it cesarean operation or natural birth, you still have to come through the body of a woman. So we all came through the same way. So why, ask yourself, then why all this person is above you? This person is the head, you are not. This person is rich, you are not. It's all this spirituality, religion that created all that among us. And some people have adopted spirituality as their way of life, that's their culture, their tradition. And some people say, no, religion is the way, you know, they believe. So they begin to speak what they believe. And they don't care to consider, you know. No matter what it is, at least this thing called death, death is not evil. It should teach you a lot of things in life. Death should teach you, no matter who you are, you have a limit. Death should teach you that. No matter what you say you possess in this life, one day you will leave that thing or that thing will leave you. Whether that thing is naturally made or man-made, you must leave that thing or that thing leave you. You cannot in the body you have or this body you have, with this body you cannot live forever unless you are eternal person. You are eternal spirit. Yet you cannot live with, I don't say in, I say you cannot live with this body forever because you are energy, you transform. So when you transform, you cannot continue with the old body. Although that body was part of you, but you have to leave it, right? So this thing is simple. And when you understand life, especially your life, you will no longer choose to be a slave of anyone, whether it's invisible God or visible gods and goddesses. But now you begin to live your life. And that's the problem the people who believe in God are having. They were trained to become dogs. Instead of living like human beings, they are living like animals. They are trained to become sheep. Instead of living like or reasoning like human beings, they begin to reason like animals, sheep. So, and when you show them, listen, this God does not exist. This God you are preaching to us does not exist. They get upset. So I call them, you know, I used to call them police dog, but I found that police dog is better. Because police dogs are trained to sniff and they catch the culprits that they are criminals or people that are possessing some contraband and all that. So they are trained to sniff and catch them. But religious dogs or God dogs, they are not trained to do even good for themselves. They are trained to hate themselves and to hate anyone who don't believe what they believe. Although they claim to love you. They love you, but they don't really care about you, because somebody that loves you will not say you will go to hell for not believing what they believe. No, yeah, they profess to love you. Love is empty words. Love is emotional thing. It does not last. Anyway, that's somebody that you are saying betray you today, or that person you are calling your ex today used to be your lover. Oh, I love him so much. I love her so much. Oh, he's one in the billion. I don't know what I would do without him or her. But today, both of you are no longer together. Both of you have moved on with your life in different directions. All right, so because it's love. That's why they tell you God is love and love is of God. Have you seen God? No. So love is bullshit. Anyone that tell you I married him because of love is bullshit. There's nothing like marrying anyone or being with anyone out of love. It will never last. Okay? There is condition why you are with that person. There's something you see in or about that person that make you say, okay, I'm going to stay with this person. It has nothing to do with love. Love as is emotion, okay? It has nothing. Love, what you have is supposed to have is caring about for one another is natural thing. You don't need any commandment or any law to tell you to care about your family members. You don't need any commandment. You don't need that, because there was no commandment for them to bring you forth. Your mother and your father, there was no commandment that said, oh, okay, you must. You have sex and have this person, so person. No, it's natural. That's why you see people, even prostitutes, get pregnant. If it's time for them, if they're in the mood to get pregnant, they must get it. Nothing will stop it. So you don't need commandment to live. You don't need law. Anything you call law, whether you call it the law of nature or law of, it's man that made up all those things, and man can break them. Every law that man made was made to be broken. You can break them. That's why some people in sports, they call it a record. Oh, somebody has set record. You know, they say this person has break that record. You don't say because, okay, this person set so record. That's how it will be forever. It's natural. It's not. Because somebody, he break that record. There's somebody else that can break that record. So when you say somebody is world power, is somebody just group of people that made that person world power or other? There if there's other people or the other person that is stronger than that person, but because that person have not show up, this person is bragging. I mean, you are not. So religious people always get offended when they see my post or when they see my video or when they see my stuff on social media. They get offended. Now, I didn't say you don't exist. I don't say Christians don't exist. I don't say Muslims don't exist. I don't say Jewish people don't exist. I say God, the God you worship, the God you say cares about you, the God you say loves you. I said that God does not exist. That means you are lying to yourself because somebody lied to you first. It was somebody that told you about that God. No God have shown up and said, this is me. Everything or every God you're talking about, you have not seen that God in reality. You only see the God somebody taught you, wrote about. Then you because you believe it, you give that abstract idea power that you can see that idea in your dream, in your vision, in your revelation, in your trance. You know, you can see it, but not in reality. It becomes your personal experience. What do those evangelists or those who go for evangelism or missionaries, what do they tell people? He said, make Jesus your Lord, your personal Lord and Savior. Personal. Jesus shouldn't be personal because you said that Jesus died for the whole world. So he's supposed to be the Lord and Savior of everyone, whether they believe in him or not. He's supposed to be the Savior and the Lord of everyone. If you say that he died for everyone, you say God loves you so much, he sent Jesus and died for you. Then why are you still struggling with sin? Why are you still struggling with those things you say Jesus died for? You still turn to blame yourself because you have been trained as dog, not only attacking somebody like me, even yourself, you attack yourself. Luke chapter 14, 26, Jesus said that he that does not hate his father, hate his mother, hate his brother, hate his sister, hate his wife, hate his children, even himself, is not worthy to be his disciple. Then I ask you, what type of stupid thing is that? Your own family members that suffered with you, your own parents, your own siblings. Now somebody demanded that you must hate them. Some people say, no, it means putting God, Jesus first. That's nonsense. Why would you put Jesus first before your loved ones? Jesus never showed up. You never seen Jesus. You never seen God. Why would you put God first? The idea of putting God first shows you that God is man-made. If God is God, you don't need to put God first. He's supposed to put himself there. He's supposed to be there. Why are you putting God? Because God is man-made. You carry idols about. Idols have legs. They cannot walk by themselves. It's people that have legs that carries idol. So they tell you to put God first in your life. You are stupid to do that or to listen to them. Anyone that tell you that is ignorant, and that person wants you to be ignorant like him. That's why your pastors are just as ignorant as you are. But you keep going to them, then they keep taking advantage of you, knowing that you believe their thoughts, says the Lord, knowing that you believe their dreams, knowing that you believe their visions. They keep giving it to you and taking your substance, taking your money. And when you fail, you blame devil or yourself. Then when you succeed, you praise God and you are a man of God. And you don't see that you are stupid. I used to be that stupid. You don't see that you are moron. I used to be that moron. You don't see that you are just a believer without facts. I used to be a believer without facts. I used to preach God. I used to preach Jesus in lies. But now I am preaching God and Jesus in truth. No more in lies. No more in make-believe. It's fact. Factual. If there is God, I need to see God. I need to see means to know. If there is Jesus, I need to see Jesus. I need to see God. If Jesus exists, not just believe. No, I need to see. Before I bought this car in May, I was saying I will buy a car. We buy a car, right? Okay, now should I continue saying I will buy a car? I will buy it. No, because I've seen the car. But they tell you, you will not see this God. You will not see this Jesus. You so much believe in and you preach and defend until you die. It's after death. In death, Imagine somebody promising you you will have something after you die. That thing is useless to you. That's why God is useless to you. Jesus is useless to you, because the only time they tell you God and Jesus will be real to you is when you die. The dead has no power. The dead know nothing. It's even in your book. He said the dead, he said a living dog is better than a dead lion. So long he is dead, it's not, there's not any promise that promise you afterlife you will inherit anything. No, that is from the evil ones. People that have stolen from you gave you that. People that have planned to destroy your life gave you that. It is time you wake up and trash them and stop being religious dog. Stop being God dog. Stop being Jesus dog. Backing and running away from people who are telling you the factual truth. You only said, oh, you are Antichrist. That's how you back. You are pagan. You are devil. You are demon. You are going to hell. All backing, empty words. You can't defend even what you are saying. You can't prove what you are saying. Because they are empty words. You cannot stand. People like, you cannot contradict me. You cannot resist me. Because I have proofs why you have belief. You cannot prove your belief. I can prove my knowledge. I can prove my point. I'm telling you, this is it. I tell you, if I will do something, I will go ahead and do it. If I tell you I will do something or I can do something, then you ask me to do it. I cannot do it. Will you take me serious? No, that's the same way you're supposed to consider your belief or your faith. You say with your God, all things are possible. But look at COVID-19. Your God have not done anything. And this morning, I even read and I deleted, I refused to approve it on my group. Somebody made a post. He said COVID-19 versus God. Then under, he said God wins. Do you see how stupid they are? They are like animals. Where has God won over COVID-19? As we are speaking right now, thousands are dying, still dying in America. America, not in Africa. America, not in Nigeria. America, the president of America said it was a hoax. Now he bowed and pretending like he does not exist anymore. Let me be talking my talking point. I don't want to tell people anything about it anymore. Saying that if I think is it about 90 or is it 90 or 60% of it is harmless, and you see dogs like him believing this nonsense he's saying. Many people are dying. The Brazilian president was following Donald Trump. He said also COVID-19 is not, now he's in quarantine. He was tested positive. And in Brazil, you see the greatest statue of Jesus over their land. But yet you see some believers, especially those living in Africa, say COVID-19 versus God. God wins. Win where? You are suffering. They lock you down. You still say God wins. You cannot go even to worship that God where you believe that God was, or you used to hear the testimonies, experience God's presence. They lock it down, say you're not coming. You still say God wins. And you tell me you are not stupid. And you get upset when somebody like me call you stupid, call you moron. You say I'm insulting you. No, you are the one insulting yourself. When you are defending or speaking for God that you say to be almighty, say to be your creator, so say to be the one that can do all things, you are stupid. You are insulting yourself. You are not reasoning and living as you're supposed to, as a human being. You are living like animal, and you are proud to be that. You say, I'm a sheep of the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd. I am proud to be that. I am a proud Catholic. I'm a proud Christian. I'm a proud Muslim. I'm a proud, you know, bullshit. You keep accepting, insulting yourself, thinking you know what you are doing. You don't. So you should stop insulting yourself and start living life as human being. Stop being God dog, God police dog. You're defending God. You are speaking for God. How dare you mock your creator? Okay, he's my creator. Then why are you coming against me? If God is my creator and I am mocking that God, I did not mock you. You are not my creator, right? Then why not you think? If there is God, God would have dealt with me. God cannot deal with me. He cannot. You say God will do something bad. You see, there is nothing wrong or there's nothing bad that will suffer that you are not suffering or you have not suffered or you are not suffering more than me. Imagine somebody living in Nigeria or in Africa saying that I must suffer and I've been living in America. Just by location, I am enjoying more than you. Even if I don't have a dime, I don't have anything in my pocket, I am enjoying life more than you just simply by living in America. Yet you will open your stinking dirty mouth, backing, bah, 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 bah. You will see, my God will reveal himself. When will God reveal himself to you and deliver you from that poverty? You are, especially those living in Nigeria, don't you know that your country is the world headquarters of poverty? New York City in America, not the whole America, New York City is the world capital of what? Finance, banking, money. In other words, yeah, you have it. You have that power, control power. But look at your whole country. Your country that has been existing since 1914. And they worship God in mosque, worship God in church. Yet they become the world headquarter, capital of poverty. Yet you're talking about your God being good. No, your God is useless. And you that believe in that God is also useless to yourself. That's why you are backing for that God. You become God dog. And not even God dog that have teeth. You are a toothless God dog. You cannot do anything. You know how many times you have passed sentence against me? You have said that we die for years now. I'm still here. Some of you have died that predicted that I cannot see you online anymore. Maybe you have died. Or you are suffering terribly. You don't have any money to pay your own bills. Yet you come defending the God that left you in that situation. Oh my God, will not allow me to be ashamed. This thing must happen. Then it did not happen. He said, will not be well with my enemies. My enemies will not prevail. They already prevail. They rape your daughter. They kill somebody in your family. They do all that evil. Your God did not prevent it. Yet you keep saying, I know the God I serve. No, you don't. You are a believer. And because you have been trained to back and run away from people that have proof, you keep doing the same thing. It is time you have a rethink. Ask yourself that simple question. Read it. Job chapter 35. I mean, those of you that believe in the Bible, read Job 35 verse 10. Ask yourself, where is my God? Where is this God they preach to me is doing wonderful? And stop backing for God. Stop speaking for God. Any God that cannot speak for himself must be trashed. Any God that cannot fight for himself must be trashed. If you're speaking for God, you are just a toothless dog. In Judges chapter 6 verse 31, the father of Gideon said, if Baal is God, anyone that fight for Baal must be put to death by morning. And that's why you remain in suffering, in penury, in poverty, because you keep speaking for God instead of you to speak for yourself and do something better for your life. You can do better for yourself. As like I said yesterday, you are better than God. God cannot do anything for you. You can do a lot of things for yourself. You can even help people. God cannot help the people that worship him. Look around you, say it is well with you. What about that people, somebody sitting beside you in your church, in your mosque, or in your family? Why is it not also well with them and all of you worship the same God? Your pastor sit on high exalted chair. You sit on plastic chair. You say it is well with you. You are stupid. And when you come online, you begin to back. Then when we talk, you're wrong because you are trying to back and the run. Tell them if you don't believe, you will perish. They tell you to back and run your back. They say when you are running, make sure you dust the dust from your shoe. So they don't preach in winter. They don't preach in spring. They preach in when do you have dust? In summer, right? Yeah, summer. That's when you have dust or fall. So they fall away, they run away. It is time you wake up, my people, especially you that is African. Can't you see the condition of your own continent? Can't you see the condition of your own people? If your God exists, there should be no reason for you or any member of your family, of your village or town or country to be suffering. You know the suffering. It masks you, it covers you in every angle, yet you still say, no, I'm not suffering. It is well with me. They tell me to say, let the weak say, I am strong. I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich. The one that tell you to say you are rich while you are poor is taking your money. And you are poor. He's supposed to be giving to you, not collecting. Any pastor that is collecting tithes and offering from you is wicked. They are thieves. That's why I call them impostors and thieves. They are selling to you product that does not exist. God does not exist. Jesus does not exist. Yet they tell you they exist and collect your money for it. You are paying for your own ignorance. You are paying for your own fear. If you must pay, pay for knowledge. When you get that knowledge, you will see how better you will live your life. It is time you wake up. Stop being dog for God. Stop being dog for Jesus. Be who you are. You are human. You are life. You are the truth. You are the way. You are the energy. You are the frequency. You are infinite. You are unchangeable. You are indestructible. You are eternal. Know yourself and live free. Peace.